What are you saying?
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas finding he loves me and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes. I think so.
You think so?
Well, I've never even met his parents and he's never met mine, and I just need to be sure.
That he's the one?
That the family is to get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What are you saying?
I'm saying that we are who we are and they're from Ohio.
Ohio! A swing state! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
That's what I mean.
You're right. This is important. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
No. But we have to tell your mother.
Oh, please, Daddy. She'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
You don't want me to tell your mother you're getting married?
After dinner, and we're all friends, then you can tell her.
But I've never kept anything from your mother.
Daddy, please.
But...
If you love me,
but...
do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife, say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do? Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
One tiny little secret, Daddy, please, please.
Okay, okay, I promise I won't tell your mother.
Thank you, Daddy. Our little secret, right?
Yes, yes, of course, Paloma. Our little secret. Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up as time slips by. When did she become someone else's job? Someone else to beg and flop and wonder why, oh why? Wednesday's growing up. She went Thursday before you know it. A troubling thing. A secret in the house. A boy, a girl, a ring.
Wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen smiling. Like this. Maybe it's this boy.
This boy? Don't be silly. Ha! Ah, in fact, I say double ha. Ha ha! You yourself said puppy love, no? Come, my darling. I feel the urge to take you upstairs. Let's go upstairs.
Gomez.
On the other hand, she is a healthy young woman, like you were. Oh, like you are. And she could even get married, like you did.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Of course, I didn't think of that.
Besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Of course, but what if, and I have no reason to say this, but what if someone stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar's shingles.
No. No!
I think Wednesday and I should have a little chat.
Like a bull in a ring, like a moderate right wing, I'm proud. Like a fly in my teeth, or the New York DMV, I'm proud. With my wife to my left, and my daughter to my right, and the thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I can choosing my blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a bolt in a lock, or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground, or like theater in the ground, I'm trapped. I can cry, I can lie, I can simply up and die, but I fear the dice have broken my cap. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cage? How trapped, 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 oh. That keeps me here and coming back for more. She stokes the Addams fire, she harbors its desire. I never tell her lies, but when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? She tied up me her heels instead of sniffing in me. Oh, big girl, now that's true, tell me what I must do. I groan, would I rather curse a stone? Why from wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong, and we'll try to get along. But I'll fail, have to fail, shove my coat into the nail. If I laugh, if I snap, maybe then I would be strong. Then I wouldn't be strong.
This dinner has to go okay.
It will if you let me blow up this Lucas guy.
Oh, Pugsley. Ever since I've met him, I just want to laugh and cry, and everything seems so right and wrong at the same time. And then sometimes, I just want to rip his flesh off and eat them up until there's nothing left. I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled. And I think I know. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do?
Well, you got some real issues.
Fly away, little birdie. Mother always said be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction.
Ah!
But I think I like it.
That was good, that was good.
I think I like it.
Do it again.
night in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies at picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow bites and Christmas Eve sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets and afternoon banana splits, angels watching while I sleep and Liberace's greatest hits have got me pulled in a new direction. If they keep insisting, I'll stop resisting. Just watch me pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark, not obey every spark, but the boy has a bite better far than his bark. And you better fight too. Do it's truly taboo. As I'm pulled in a new direction.
See dogs. Oh, Disney World. She's in a state to entertain guests. We have to cancel the dinner.
No!
What?
I mean, we can't do that.
Why?
Because then there would be no dinner.
Gomez, do you love your daughter? Do you care for her mental well-being?
Of course.
Do you want her to be put on heavy medication and spend the rest of her days hating us because we let her ruin her life?
Head off for
Gomez! Would you stop that?
I think we should have this dinner.
Why?
Because we need to introduce her to the real world.
Are you out of your mind? Have you seen the world lately? Now stop prattling and go tell her the dinner's off.
But Carla...
You're the father. The father is the counselor. And it is after 25 years of marriage. You can't do this one thing for me, then I just don't know what.
Okay, family meeting about tonight. Now, here's the schedule. First, we have drinks like, hi, nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Okay. And then they'll want to see the house, and then we can have dinner at 8, and they can be back at their hotel by 9:30.
Wednesday, your father has something to tell you.
Actually, Paloma, your mother and I have had second thoughts.
What about?
About this dinner. It all seems so... quick?
It's not quick! Oh, Daddy, please, it's just a dinner, and they're dying to meet you. And I promised Lucas, and you know how I hate to break a promise.
Yes, but your mother
and I... Daddy, please, I am your only daughter and your eldest child, and if you cannot do this one thing for me, well then, I just don't know what.
Oh, well, maybe... just a little dinner?
Oh, thank you, Daddy!
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. So, dinner it is. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Ugh. Oh, God, please, no, not the game.
But it's family tradition.
But it's my dinner.
Oh, but it's my house, darling. Dinner and the game.
One out of two, Paloma. Don't push it.
Then can we at least all act normal?
Define normal!
Shh! Normal is an illusion, darling. What's normal for the spider is a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please. They're normal people, not like you, not like me. Please, can't we be an average family? Night, that's all I want, that's all I need from you. One normal house without a mouse to feed a plant or two. You must admit we're not what people call laid back. So can't we muse a bit and lose the basic black
you can.
Normally.
Can you achieve a kind of common man? You have to swear to me, yes, promise to the core. It's almost 6 o'clock, they're almost at the door. On all the Addams ancestors who've ever walked a ride. One normal night. Woo!
Okay, Lucas, enough is enough. Give me the map.
I don't see any houses.
That's because there aren't any, Alice. We're in the middle of some godforsaken park.
Central Park, dear. Designed in 1857 by...
Wait!
What?
I know where we are! It's where I first saw her. I was lost in the park, and then a pigeon dropped at my feet with an arrow in it. And I looked up, and there she was. Wednesday with a crossbow.
Oh, what?
A crossbow. You know.
This girl walks around with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a permit.
Good. Good choice, son. Okay, listen up. Now, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go back to the hotel, and you and I are gonna have a little talk about...
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
See what you did? You got your mother rhyming again. Let's go back to the hotel.
No! One normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine. Tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food.
He seems like such a nice young man.
But they're not right for each other.
Not right for each other? What do you mean not right for each other? Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was Nausea right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the sock vaccine? Was rehab right for Charlie Sheen? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trick. Normal is hard to attain, right? Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain, but this is their moment and this is your chance. So if you don't want to remain, start singing out loud.
What?
Love.
No.
Love.
Why?
Love. Only affairs of the heart. Look, the choice is yours. Either you help these kids or you're stuck here for eternity! So?
Yes! Yes! Right!
Good!
Love lets our spirits part.
You got it! So, let the normalcy start! Protect and rally round, let's eat them in the bed! What the-
had a little trouble finding the place. Looks like someone shot out all your street lamps. Boy, look at this place. They just move in or what?
No, this is how they live in New York. They spend all their money on rent and have nothing left for furniture.
Mal Beinecke. And this is my wife, Alice. That's my son, Lucas. And you are? Nice talking to you. Earth to Alice. We landed in Weirdo City. I say drinks and bye-bye.
Oh, Mal, be open to experience and welcome in the new. Reach deep in your surprise bag. There might be a gift for you.
Honey, my surprise bag is so full, I can hardly lift it. That guy who patted me down at the airport, he slipped me his telephone number. I don't think I can handle any more surprises.
Come on, Dad, lighten up. These are your kind of people, real salt of the earth.
Oh yeah? Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, 1715, the Spanish warship Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Captain General Rondondo Ventana Lenguana Don Jose Cuervo. Leaves for Madrid, bound for the New World. 3 weeks later, he is still in Spain, as Madrid is 400 nautical miles away from the Atlantic Ocean. A stubborn man, he sets sail anyway, only to sink 6 months later off the southern coast of Florida. A hostile land, infested with mosquitoes, rattlesnakes, and many retired Jewish peoples. But enough about us. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume. And a lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be Lucas. Unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son, with a massive thyroid problem. I go too far. No matter. Deny it. She is young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez Florencia Addams, at your service. Allow me to introduce you to my wife, La Dueña, the mother of my children, el amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia. Duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez. So very pleased, Mr. Beinecke.
Mrs. Addams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Alice.
And you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I was named after my Uncle Lucas, who got lost in the woods and ate his own leg.
They don't need to know that.
No. Beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his own tongue. He talks like this. How are you?
Thank you, Mother. Hi, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress.
A yellow dress.
Paloma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Would you excuse us for a moment? I will not have that color in my house.
I'm just being normal, okay?
Darling, we don't wear bright colors. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination.
It's a lovely dress, Wednesday. Yellow is the color of the warming sun. Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the world the love in which we all believe? Why not wear our heart where all can see on our sleeve? Yellow is...
A lovely sentiment about the color yellow. Oh, look. Everybody, it's Wednesday's little brother, Pugsley, just returning from Bible study. Say hello, Puggles.
Hello! Want to make a donation?
Of course, sweetheart. What are you collecting for?
Just put some money in the can and no one get hurt.
Boys, normal out there.
And this is our little grandma, the pride and soul of the Addams.
I just came from the hospital. Cardiac ward. Boy, they're dropping like flies over there.
I didn't get that.
I hope you are staying in shape. Grains, fresh fruit, 40 minutes on the treadmill.
I know I should, but I don't do any of that.
Well, then, you're gonna die, honey.
Are you ready for some football?
Chester's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that sunbitch go. He's on the 20. He's around the 30. And touchdown! The crowd goes wild.
And this is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet ya.
Thank you, Fester. Thank you, Grandma. All right. Very good. Now get out.
Goodbye.
From the extensive Addams family caves.
Children, your excuse.
Come on, Lucas. Dad, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma. Leave the door open, you hear?
Ah, your concern they will add.
Yes.
Not to worry, my friend. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. He tries anything, she will rip out his throat. To the children.
Excuse me, do you have a little girl's room?
Oh, we used to, but we let them all go.
Gomez, come with me, dear. I'll show you.
Ah, wonderful. A grand tour for the missus, and the missus and I will go downstairs for some guy stuff. And then, dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
Oh, yeah? What kind of game?
Have you ever played charades?
Yeah.
Well, it's nothing like that. Come, Mr. Beinecke. Lunch.
Did you get the flowers?
Oh, yes. And
the lovely poem. Wherever did you find it?
I wrote it.
No.
When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem gets it off my chest. They come to me, they take no time. They just pop out and always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing so many need, but so few have.
Healthcare?
Love, of course.
Let's not talk about anything else but love. Worth repeating. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds, and
you know they're gonna freak when we tell them.
My father won't.
Why not?
I already told him.
What? You told your father? Your father with the sword? You told him we were getting married just like that.
He's totally cool with it. Mostly.
I thought we were going to tell them all together.
We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw it up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look, it may seem old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Then leave it to me. It's all going according to plan.
What plan? There's no plan!
That is the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's just a simple dinner. What could go wrong? Come on.
Aww. Be patient, and soon the way will be clear. Focus your fear, and troubles all will disappear. Let's not talk about anything more.
Interesting chair. Antique.
15th century. The heretic's chair. Once owned by Tomas de Torquemada, the Grand Inquisitor of Madrid.
You collect this kind of stuff?
A man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me? I collect instruments of persuasion. You ask? Go on. Ask. Ask.
Why?
It's fun! The history of the world told through agony and dismemberment! Here, get up, let me show you. You sit down, they ask you a question, they don't like your answer. Oh, that'll get you believing, eh? Here, sit down, let me show you.
Some other class.
Okie dokie. So, how about these crazy kids, eh?
What about?
They seem very fond of each other, no?
Yes. Not like they're getting married.
Married? Of course not. Who said anything about marriage? I mean, they do get married young these days, don't they?
I don't know what they do.
Then, speak of you. The Beinecke saga. Your lives, your hopes, your dreams. Your son.
Lucas?
Yes.
He's a bit soft, like his mother. But when he gets out of college, I'll toughen him up. Teach him the business. Make him a man.
May I say something? You and I feel we understand each other. Do you feel this?
No.
Come, Mr. Beinecke, let me show you the moat. Did you bring your swim trunks? Nah, never mind. Let's just be a little crazy.
Ah, and this is Cousin Helga from Baden-Baden.
Who's that, looking over her shoulder?
Oh, no, that's her other head.
She has two heads?
Well, you know what they say.
And who's that man in the dress?
Well, that's Aunt Herman, Wednesday's uncle, twice removed. And here's Gomez and me at our wedding.
What's that?
Our wedding vows.
That's so romantic. We promised to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promised to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
And you're still married?
More than ever.
Boy, sure doesn't work that way in our house.
How does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is a nice quiet goose. If I told Mal my secrets, all hell break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of a marriage is it where you keep secrets?
A long one.
Secrets are the enemies of passion. Speaking true will get you through the day. Truth is not a thing that one should ration, but I think you think of it that way. Never keep a sin inside the closet. Always give the facts a fighting chance. Every time you do, it's a deposit in the long-term life of your own hands. Keep no secrets if you want to.
Maybe a writer, or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner? Why?
Well, you get to look at the inside of people's bodies, and they don't care, because, you know, they're dead.
Where did you find him?
We found each other. It's kind of a miracle. Gomez! Oh my God, Daddy!
What are we gonna do?
Let's just tell her it's going to be fine.
You promised after dinner.
What were the three of you whispering about?
The weather.
The news.
The economy.
The economy.
The weather.
The news.
We're gonna go now.
Come, Lucas, let me show you them all. Have you ever seen the rat the size of a dachshund?
No, sir.
Gomez! What's going on?
Nothing. We were just talking.
That wasn't talking, that was conspiring.
No, it was talking. Conspiring is,
That's what you were doing!
Carida, stop this foolishness.
You're keeping something from me.
Kara, I have never kept anything from you in my life, and may lightning strike me when I stand if I'm keeping anything from you now.
Then it should come to this.
Here, Kara, I feel the urge to take you into my arms.
No, Gomez.
What?
Not today.
But you've never turned down a trip to heaven.
Not today. I'll be in my room until you're ready to share, like a proper husband.
Morticia mia! Like a bug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man growing gray when his wife says no today. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Who could conceive it? What if I and one tiny lie started civil war? What if the line's been crossed, out of commitment lost? How is that possible? Could that be possible?
But what if they hate each other?
What if they don't?
Be like me. Look on the bright side.
You make me so crazy.
Maybe you two should get a room.
Pugsley, could you stop sneaking around like that?
It's my house too, okay?
Excuse me while I kill my brother.
Oh,
take care of this. Yo, what up? It's the Pugster. My guy. Little man. What's up? We're watching. You're supposed to catch him. Whoa.
You think I'm cool?
Because
you're not cool.
Yeah, well, your sister thinks I'm cool.
She'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
I'm under a lot of stress. My sister is having an identity crisis.
We're gonna go now.
Can I come?
Sorry, Puggles. I'm with Lucas now. Bye.
But wait! Wait! What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor?
life?
Too long.
Tell me about it.
Hold on. What are you doing?
Restocking. Grandma's private stash. Herbs, potions, and remedies. Nature's candy. No prescription needed.
What? This one?
Peyote.
What's it do?
Makes you run around naked in the woods.
What about this one?
Buku leaf. You got somebody giving you a hard time?
Maybe.
Sprinkle a little of that on his toast, and an hour later, he's in a padded room screaming, I am Spartacus!
Grandma, what if there was this girl who met this person, and he's all like, hey, it's the Puckster, what up, little man? And she's all like, golly, and we're gonna go now. What would you give her?
Nothing. She's your sister. Be happy for her.
But what if she doesn't get rid of him? What if all the good times are already behind me?
That's life, kid. You lose the thing you love.
Tell me about it. What's this one?
Acrimonium! You want to stay away from this baby.
What?
Takes the lid off the id. Brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
Once we get that, and Mary Poppins turns into Medea.
I don't understand your references.
Well then stop the damn texting and pick up a book every once in a while. Now stop whining about your sister and start worrying about you and how you're gonna live your life. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and flee on little fairy wings. And stare at my stuff, or I'll rip your leg off and bury it in the backyard. I love you.
Magnificent feast, all thanks to my fabulous lady wife, from whom I keep nothing. This dinner puts me in the mind of my great ancestor, Hector Fernando Escondido Chimichanga. A man hated by the church, but clever with a quip. In fact, while being burned alive, he said keep it pink in the middle and a little crispy on the outside.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please, not the game. It's really late.
But it's a family tradition.
Pugsley, could you just go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will.
Carter, maybe the game's not such a good idea.
Thank you, Daddy.
No, it is a good idea. And if it isn't, then somebody will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
Actually, the game's a good idea. The best of all ideas.
What kind of game?
We call it Obligación de Revelar.
Ooh, Spanish! What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Exactly. Everyone takes a sip from the sacred family chalice.
And confesses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
For what?
For there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Sure you would.
Oh, no. No, 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 no.
And now, Gomez will break the ice. My husband has something he needs to disclose.
No, no, the host always goes last.
Lurch! The sacred chalice.
This is the sacred chalice of Adam's family past. Open my digitalis, held fast, die cast. Hid in the sweet libation, salvation resides. Feel the sweet sensation, revelation provides. Disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darker secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, I'm playing. Disclosure, with all these crazy happy people.
Disclosure,
it's a head of a fool. One's a villain of the lady jumping. Doesn't matter if you're right or left. Once upon a time, there was a man who had a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, and yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who worshipped the very ground his wife walked on. Thank you. And one day, the man met a fox, and the fox gave him a box of red wood and Spanish leather. What's in the box? Asked the kindly man. And the fox said, a little secret, but you must never open it. So the man went home, and his wife said, let's open it anyway. And the man said, don't push it, honey. We got a good thing going, and we don't want to ruin it. So they never did open it, and everyone lived happily ever after. Full disclosure?
Well, we'll just have to come back to you, won't we? Wednesday, sir. Pass.
Yes, Chester, the chalice.
I am in love.
Aww.
You're probably thinking, what could a fat bald person of no specific sexuality know about love? But I too am in love. Fester love.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon.
Aww.
The moon? He's in love with the moon.
Yeah, that's
That's the most beautiful thing I ever heard!
Oh, and I haven't told her yet.
Aww.
Full disclosure.
Full disclosure,
just embrace it and swoon!
Embrace it and swoon!
Fall from grace or fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon!
Close your sermon with the signature tune.
And call it full disclosure.
Wednesday, sir.
No.
Me! 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 Age before beauty. The chalice!
Kid and I had a little heart-to-heart before. I told him to use his time wisely. Look who's talking. I'm 102. I've got shingles and arthritis and diabetes types 1 and 2. And when I break wind, it could stop the windmills in an old Dutch painting. But I've still got one more round left in me. Call me Cougar. But 5 will get to 10, there's a couple of 90-year-old hotties out there just waiting for grandma. Full disclosure. Full disclosure. I just peed!
Oh. You should have put you down years ago. No, All right, Wednesday's turn.
Not yet. Daddy, talk to her.
I've still got the fox problem, hello, man.
Wednesday, your turn. The chalice, please. Where's the chalice?
Yes, now with a dash of potion, my sister blows her cool. Hopefully in slow motion, she'll drop, she'll drool. One sip of acrimonium, and then she will change. Boy, oh boy, her full disclosure's gonna be strange.
Full disclosure,
the moment of truth.
How to let the throat like they prove. This is torture, I can live back and forth. Used to your sophisticated New York lifestyle. So if your
back to the real America. Full disclosure. Lucas, help your mother off the table.
You were right, Lucas.
Right about what?
Thanks anyway, Daddy.
Thanks for what?
We should have just told her.
Told me what?
It doesn't matter. Lucas and I love each other and we're getting married.
What?
That's what you kept from me?
No secrets, huh?
I mean, is this any way to end an act? Well, actually, yes. But it'd be a little better if the guests couldn't leave just yet, don't you think?
Yeah!
All right, dead people, give her some water!
Looks like you'll be staying the night. That's what happens when you play.